That was incoming. I picked myself up over there about 10 feet. I'm all black and blue, like just like this. I get black and blue when somebody grabs me on the arm. This is how I get. Concussion. Explosion, I was all black and blue. Ached all over, but I just had to scratch. But my friend from Yohei Sagami, who was on the ground, I turned him over. He got hurt. Jugular vein here. And the blood was just every time his pulse would beat, stream of blood would come out. Hit one of his main arteries and then just the blood was just he lost too much blood and he died. He was the first Nisei to be killed in France.
The first group of survivors of the 442nd came to my village in 1971. 17 members of the K Company. I was named to guide their guy, and they were really, really emotional. To have only 17 survivors in their company, losing all their friends in a couple of yards over there. They just get together and begin to cry. Sergeant Ben Inakatsu, Hawaii, 442nd Infantry, World War II. He died the day of the liberation of my village on October 19th. There's a lot of his grave over there. Just died in my village.
After the liberation of Brières, the soldiers of the 100th 442nd were in a state of great exhaustion. Then, they were ordered to rescue the Texas Battalion, surrounded by the Germans in the Vosges Mountains. Later, this rescue mission would be designated as one of the 10 major battles in U.S. Army history.
We just came back from a four-day engagement against the enemy. So the first thing when we get together is, come on, get it back, let's play game, you know? Then the sergeant came and said, bad news, we're gonna hit the front tomorrow.
We said, oh, everybody starts to gee, they don't give us a rest. We like to stay in the back and go drink beer.
We knew we were being used because we were expendable. And we welcomed this because we felt that here was the opportunity we wanted to demonstrate what we're worth.
The Texas Battalion was surrounded by the German military. Several rescue attempts by the Texas Regiment were suppressed by the German forces.
And I remember it was just my birthday. I was 21 years old. And I was real happy, you know. It was a terrible condition. It was raining, it was cold, it was muddy. The Germans were shelling us, and we're trying to attack a hill. The machine guns were shooting at us. And all of a sudden, a German popped up and shot me. But somehow, he was only like from me to you, just 6-7 feet away. And he just point blank missed. And I turned around and I shot him. And I ran up and I grabbed him by the neck. He was just a kid, maybe a 14 or 15 year old kid. He's probably more scared than I was, you know. And just, he shot at me and missed me. I should have been dead. But, you know, it just things like that. And you see your friends get shot, and it just bodies flying and just flying. And you just can't forget those things. And, you know, somebody next to you, right away, he's gone. You just keep going. You can't stop. You have to keep going. October 27, 1944, I became 21. That was, I just remember that day so well, and I should have been dead.
I was one of those that walked into the forest and boom, I tripped the booby trap. And it was wet and cold, so the charge must have gotten wet, because even if it exploded, the blast went away from me. Mind is complete blank to what I did afterward. Did I run somewhere or go hide, or what did I do?
And one of the problems in that region is that heavy forest with thick trees that when they do shell, always the shell will burst on the top of the tree and the shrapnel will just come down like an umbrella. So there was no way you can avoid, getting injured.
In one case where he was about 10 feet away and I happened to be talking to him, and all of a sudden the shell came, zoom, a shrapnel, cut the top of his head off.
Just bang, 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 just continuously, and the tree bursts were coming, and everybody was trying to stay hidden behind a tree or a rock, but, you know, the shells keep bursting, coming down. That's when I got the shrapnel, big piece of shrapnel in my back. Right behind here it came in, but it came in at an angle, so it came around like this, slid right around. That big piece of red-hot shrapnel. Oh, the pain is unbearable. It just, it, not only from piercing your body, but the hot, hot metal that's inside of you, and it's just burning, and it just, it hurts so much, you can't move. You just kind of curl up. And you can't move, your body's in shock. You can't do anything.
Well, I got hit when I was in a foxhole, covering myself up, and I got hit in the back there with a piece of shrapnel. The shrapnel was too close to my spine, so they didn't take it out. I believe it's still embedded in my back.
In the morning, as we were moving out, the Germans know exactly where we were, and they were shelling us all like crazy. We had all kinds of shell coming, and one of the shell landed on top of that heavy tree that we were under. And of all the people that was there, I was the only one that got hit.
Here you can see the mountain. It's a D mountain, and it is this one, called in French La Vison. And so you see the main, this tree, three the same, took in October 1944.
Banzai Hill, they call it.
Yes, Banzai Hill, you're right. The Banzai charge was done in this mountain.
So we're trying to move our men up higher because the machine guns were firing down at us. We couldn't get going because there's too much fire. So finally he said, we'll make a Banzai charge. So we got all the whole hill. Everybody made a Banzai charge up there. Get close enough where they could throw a hand grenade at the machine gun. When you stop the machine gun from shooting, you can get up there close enough to shoot at it. That's what we had to do. But we were being pinned down all across because they had the high spot, and you're coming up, like right here, you're coming up, and they've got you. You can't get away from them. So we made the Banzai charge up the hill, and it was really something. You know, it was pretty bad. Bodies were flying all over. You know, guys were getting hit left and right.
I'm down in a hole, so I didn't see the German come around, and they started climbing the hill. They were taking the hill back, you know. Oh my God, I says, German behind there climbing the hill again. So watch out for the Germans. And Saburo Taramachi stands up and says, where? Machine gun shot him. So I crawled over to his hole and picked him up. Why'd you stand up, you know? And he tried to say something, but He went. Then I know he died. He died, man, looking at all the blood. I said, oh, God, I went.
Then I lost it.
I was mad, cried. You son of a bitch. Took my dog, zigzag up the zigzag that swing. What the swing? Then there's a rest of the person. Come on. So they said I shot 12 guys, but I don't remember how I shot. Then the other soldiers started waving handkerchiefs, giving up. But I had to watch to see that maybe the guy in back of him might have a gun. So they're all just waving their hands like this. I said, okay. So they said I took 34 prisoners, but I don't know how many I took.